Islam menjadi salah satu agama yang berkembang luas dan berhasil meraih reputasi bagus di Rusia pasca bubarnya Uni Soviet pada 26 Desember 1991. Hal ini dimungkinkan dengan adanya kolaborasi yang baik antara Islam dan komunitas agama-agama lain serta akomodasi politik pemerintahan Rusia, selain kesadaran komunitas Muslim untuk mempraktikkan Islam harmonis. Demikian disampaikan Deputy Chairman of Russia Muftis Council, Rushan Abiyasov, saat berbicara dalam public lecture Islam in Russia di Diorama Haruna Sution, Rabu 27 Februari 2019. Selain dihadiri Wakil Rektor Bidang Kerjasama Andi Faisal Bakti, Kepala Biro AKK Khairuddin, public lecture yang diselenggarakan Pusat Layanan Kerjasama Internasional UIN Jakarta ini dihadiri ratusan mahasiswa dari berbagai fakultas dan program studi di UIN Jakarta. Pada kesempatan tersebut, Abiyasov menerangkan kehidupan umat Islam di Rusia yang kini sudah lebih baik, di mana Islam telah menjadi agama terbesar kedua di Rusia setelah Kristen Ortodoks. Untuk lebih jelasnya, simak penjelasan Deputy Chairman of Russia Muftis Council, Rusan Abiyasov, berikut ini.
Your Excellencies, Professor Andy, distinguished teachers and students, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, it is an honor and privilege for me to welcome you on behalf of our delegation from Russia and on behalf of 25 million Russian Muslims with the traditional Muslim greeting Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Today I have a lecture about the history of Islam in Russia and about our Muslim community. And the image, how you know, of Russia in the world is largely associated with the Orthodox Christianity, but not many people know that Russia is home to about 25 million Muslims who have lived on its territory for many years. The history of Islam in Russia dates back to more than 1,000 years ago and tell us a story of coexistence, tolerance and cooperation of two great religions, Islam and Christianity. As for now, Muslims make up about 18% of the Russian population. Russian Muslims mainly live in two main areas. In the northern Caucasus, between the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea, and in the middle of the Volga River basin. Other areas with notable Muslim population include Moscow, St. Petersburg, and some large cities in Siberia. But of course, there are Muslim communities in every region of our big country. Majority of Russian Muslims are Sunni of Hanafi Mashab, but most Muslims in North Caucasus region are Shafi. Shia Muslims constitute not more than 5% of the total Muslim population in Russia, and they are mostly of Azerbaijani descent. So now let's dive into the history of Islam in Russia. Islam first penetrated into the modern territory of Russia in the 7th century. It happened in the Caucasus region in the city of Derbent. 40 companions of Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were buried in this city. The names of them: Abdurrahman bin Rabia radiallahu anhu, Huzaifa bin Asad radiallahu anhu, Bakir bin Abdullah, and Salman bin Rabia radiallahu anhu. And the Juma Mosque in this city is one of the oldest mosques in Russia and Eastern Europe. It was built in 733 and is still there. Now the mosque is included in the UNESCO World Heritage List. This is first place in the history of Islam in Russia. The second place in our big country is place of Bulgar. Islam gradually spread to the central parts of modern Russia with the help of trade and economic relations with the Muslim world. The first independent Muslim state in the modern territory of Russia was Volga Bulgaria. Bulgar rulers sent a letter to Abbasid Caliph al-Muqtadir asking him to send Muslim scholars to teach religion and Islamic law among Bulgars. After some time, Bulgar king decided to adopt Islam as official religion of his state. This happened in 922 AD in the presence of Abbasid delegation. It is a very important date in the history of Islam in Russia. Since then, Islam spread to other parts of modern Russia, including Siberia and Far East. Volga Bulgaria, which was the most northern stronghold of the Islamic world at that time, was famous for its towns and developed culture. Great Muslim geographers and historians of medieval period, such as Al-Balhiki and Ibn Hawqal, mentioned Bulgar in their works. In 2014, Bulgar officially became UNESCO Heritage Site. And in 2017, with the support of Russian President Vladimir Putin, the Islamic Academy was opened in Bulgar. From 10th century to 15th century AD, on the territory of modern Russia, there were several independent states which had Islam as their official religion. In 13th century, most part of Eurasian continent, including Russian territory, was conquered by Mongol Tatars under the rule of Genghis Khan. His empire was called Golden Horde. In 1312, ruler Uzbek declared Islam to be a state religion. This period was often called the Golden Age or Golden Horde. Islam continued to spread across Russian territory. Starting from 16th century, Moscow state became stronger and it started to conquer independent Muslim parts of the former Golden Horde, such as Kazan, Crimea, Siberia, Nogai, and Astrakhan Khanates. In 19th century, North Caucasus also became part of the Great Russian Empire. However, the Russian Empire allowed its population to practice Muslim religion, and in 1788, first Muslim spiritual assembly in Edinburgh was established to supervise Muslims who lived on the territory of Russian Empire. This was done by Russian Empress Catherine the Great, and it was an unprecedented move. This Muslim assembly was headed by Mufti, appointed by the government this time. And there were three qadis to help him who were appointed by the Minister of Interior from the recommendation of the Mufti. After the October Revolution in Russia in 1917, the life of Muslim community of Russia changed significantly. But by 19, 1937, Soviet government closed more than 10,000 mosques of 12,000. Up to 97% of imams and muezzins, alims, lost their position. At the same time, religious life was never completely eliminated, and the religion was never officially banned in the USSR. Muslims continued practicing their religion at homes and kept Holy Qurans in secret places. With the start of the Second World War, a lot of Russian Muslims took part against the Nazis, and the Russian Mufti even declared this war a holy war. By 1944, there were four spiritual administrations of Muslims in Soviet Union, which supervised the religious life of Muslims living in the Soviet Union. These administrations lasted until the collapse of the Soviet Union. After the Second World War, and especially since the mid-60s, Soviet government started to encourage Muslim clergy to participate in the public life of the country and international conferences. Official imams started to visit friendly Muslim countries. One event was very important in this period. In 1956, the first president of Indonesia, Ahmad Sukarno, decided to visit the Soviet Union and asked the Soviet government to include the visit of the Cathedral Mosque of St. Petersburg into the program of his visit. However, this mosque was closed by Soviet government for several years already. So the Soviet government decided to open this mosque again, especially for the visit of President Sukarno. And since then, it was never closed again. This shows how Indonesia played an important role in the revival of Islamic life of Russian Muslims in that period. And needless to say, how friendly and strong relationships Russia and Indonesia have been enjoying now. In 1991, after the collapse of Soviet Union, a lot of democratic reforms took place in Russia. Alhamdulillah, religion activity increased and many Muslim communities started to operate on legal basis. Many new mosques were built and new Muslim communities opened in different Russian regions. For example, in shortly this 26 year, we built now more than 8,000 new mosques in this little 26 year, and more than 10,000 Muslim community, Muslim associate opened now in our country. Now there are several recognized Islamic universities and schools. For example, in Russia now we have 5 Islamic universities in the biggest city of our country. For example, like Moscow Islamic University, Kazan Islamic University in the Republic of Tatarstan, and Bashkortostan, and Islamic University in Grozny, Republic of Chechnya, and also Islamic University in Makhachkala, Republic of Dagestan in North Caucasus. And now, alhamdulillah, we have more than 8,000 courses of Islam in almost everyone who want to know about the Islam, reading Quran and Usuluddin can come to the mosques, and they have Sunday courses for everyone. It's free for who want to know about the Islam, Muslim or non-Muslim people. It's open. And now, many students, alhamdulillah, from the near countries, from the our country, the neighboring countries, come to Russia now to receive Islamic education. Russia is now known as a traditional center for the academic Islamic studies in our country. We also organize a number of national and international conferences in different religious and cultural events about Islam, interreligious cooperation, development of halal industry, and Islamic finance. For example, every year we have Quran competition. It is international Quran competition. We invite from 40 countries participants, and also from Indonesia. And alhamdulillah, every year we have big events like Holy Quran competition, like exhibition of halal industry, Moscow Halal Expo. We have many interesting international conference and many events for the education, and not only for Russian Muslims, but also for the our Muslim community. Now, the largest centralized Muslim organization in our country, in Russia, is the Russian Muftis Council, which united favorites, religions, Muslim organization across the territory of the Russian Federation. It was founded in 1996 and is headed by Mufti Sheikh Khalil bin Uddin, who has proven his authority many times over these years. Russian Muftis Council is the most credible and respected centralized Muslim religious organization in Russia, which engaged in productive activity aimed at solving problems and practicing the interest of Muslim community of Russia. And Russian Muftis Council also represented these Muslims of Russia on the international arena by developing cooperation with foreign states. Religious as and non-government organization. And now, how you know, our country is secular country. We have four traditional religion, historical. It is Orthodox, Christianity, Islam. Islam take second place for the population of our country. And we have Jewish community and Buddhist community. This is four traditional historical religion in our country. Religion in our country is separated from the state, but religions organizations are not involved in the politics. And we have cooperation, but we have cooperation with the our government, with the parliament. We are cooperated with the government, parliament, and other organizations to maintain peace, tolerance, and stability in our multi-ethnic country. For example, we have more than 190 ethnic group in our country. Ethnic group. And 50 from this ethnic group is Muslim national, our Muslim community. We have many interesting projects, and inshallah, yesterday we opened the international exhibition. It is second time, because the first time we opened like this exhibition in Brunei Darussalam last year. This year we opened in Indonesia, in Jakarta. And also in this photo exhibition you can see the pictures about our mosques, like architecture, and you can see our life, our people, our culture, our kitchen, for example, and like this. And this exhibition said about the traditions of Islam in our country, and this exhibition will open till 18 of March, yes, and you are welcome. And I take this time for the questions, and thank you for your attention. I will be glad to answer your question. Arima Kasir and Maturnuvon.